Digital signal processing is bad for musicality, no matter what it is. Be it streaming, be it noise shaping, it constantly introduces time domain deviations. It deviates. We, as humans, we hear it very well. We always find something more musical and direct sounding when it's played back in front of us. Remember that string of the violin, that kick in the kick drum, or the hit on the snare, that's unimpeded signal. There's no error correction. It just originates from the source, and the sound waves hit our ears. It's already bad enough that we have the digital version of it, so we are just basically approximating the original analog. Now we also have all this signal processing that takes place, right? So we error correct all the time to check everything is right, everything is good. Beautiful, everything is there, but the timing is off. Well, one shouldn't be surprised if one enjoys music less and less. Music is not just simple sine waves. It's a collection of sine waves which come predefined in a particular period, so time domain is fixed. So amplitude to time relationship is number one importance. That's all that really matters. To approximate the analog, there are several techniques or several technologies that have evolved over time. So the very first was the PCM, the pulse code modulation. In essence, a pulse code modulation is a predefined set bit depth with predefined sampling frequency. Everything is being quantized in terms of bit depth relative to its sampling frequency. We have different signals, but they are clearly defined in its time domain at the set sampling frequency. Now, in essence, DSD is exactly the opposite. So DSD is one bit noise which is sampled and at various variable sampling frequency, 44, 88, 100, whatever, kilohertz frequency, constantly variable. So when we have pink noise sampled at variable sampling frequency, the time domain is never constant. Now, the PCM has a full set of information to start off with. The DAC is purely switching different registers to attain, to give you the analog signal. Where in the DSD world, in order to reconstruct the signal, we need to noise shape, so extrapolate something out of this pink noise, so reconstruct its amplitude at variable increased time sampling frequencies. And then everything that is excess around it, all the noise, is then being filtered, digitally filtered and demodulated and deleted from the original signal. Now, signal processing, trying to get accuracy at the expense of time domain. Why is that? Because we want to have accuracy. We are always double checking. Is this a correct amplitude? And when we do this, we're always error correcting. Error correction means we have to check whether the bits are bits. So zeros are zeros or ones are ones. We have to have some sort of feedback loop. Feedback loop always means that we're feeding the output to input. Input to output, we are always distorting the time domain because there's always some sort of lag, because you can't have instant feeding the output to input. It doesn't work. There's always going to be some sort of shift. And those shifts can happen randomly and frequently. And so we have certain drift in the time domain, whether we like it or not. And the more signal processing we have, the more small little shifts we get. Just little tiny bit picoseconds, there's a change. We as humans can hear it very well because we perceive this as less musical. The musicality is lost. PCM was the original format in which the music was sampled, quantized. And that was originally made for the original technology, which is the R2R, resistor to resistor, ladder type of DACs. DSD came later because we had the Delta Sigma noise shaping DACs, which was lower cost alternative. It simplifies the production. One didn't have to produce all this error prone laser etching of those resistor ladders and inside the DAC chips. So one just foregone and substituted all this process with a couple of simple diodes which would switch at the very high frequencies. They create a lot of noise, and then this noise is then being filtered at the end with some sort of filtering algorithm, so digital filter, demodulator. And that's what we have today. We have CPU DSPs, so central processing units, digital signal processors, which work with one bit pink noise and set of full set of data. They are very clever filtering algorithms, very clever extrapolation, interpolation algorithms, which make everything beautiful, but forget the very most important idea that music is clearly defined by its amplitude to time domain relationship. We at S1X Audio Design trying to preserve precious time domain to amplitude relationship, because that's what really matters. Whether we get less accurate, maybe amplitude, we lost the original time domain relationship. That's far worse than losing a little bit of accuracy on the amplitude. Everything that has least amount of processing is, in my book, always going to be superior. Because if we think about what the analog signal is, it's basically anything that creates the amplitude. Be it a kick of a snare, a kick drum, the string of the guitar, violin, everything we do, this is a signal that is being generated mechanically. And that signal is propagating from the source to our ears without any change in the time domain or as sound waves travel and hit our senses, our eardrums. That's what the kind of we enjoy as humans. Is that different approaches, but one approach has a more accurate reproduction of the time domain and the other one has a more accurate reproduction of the signal amplitude. But what matters more in music, the time domain, that matters mostly. Doesn't matter how accurate you're going to reproduce your amplitude, if your time domain is off, nothing else matters. The PCM and the R2R, especially digital filterless conversion, is going to yield theoretically much better results because we are not applying digital filters. If we have a digital filterless approach in R2R, digital to analog conversion. The set of information that we sampled, that we quantized before, we do brute conversion. Whatever comes out, comes out. And it comes out at the predefined set time. We are not applying any digital filtering. So we are not trying to error correct any problems. Whatever comes out, comes out. And therefore, our approach doesn't distort the time domain. PCM feeding into a digital filterless DAC is a much closer approximation to the analog signal contained in the recording, whether it's tape or vinyl. So this is the original, authentic music. We're about to preserve the original recording. Not to beautify it, it's just keep true to the original recording. And this is what's all about. This is what we do at S1X Audio Design. We are trying to stay true to the original recording.